bitch better have my money.
Opie and Anthony.
Program Young Greg is production or on the toilet?
Oh, yeah. Production on the toilet. I was just in a production studio doing a vocal production out of my mouth, and he's producing out of his ass. Is that what you're saying?
I think he's dropping little Greg pellets.
Pellets.
And, of course, young Patricky.
Yes. It is our, yes, Patrice O'Neill.
Hola.
Always a pleasure here on the XM radio side of our program.
Genada.
And, yeah, it's the last one before our little Christmas vacation.
Can I get your little Brazilian friend to come back in again? Give me a Christmas.
She was in for like a fucking week.
Yeah.
She kept coming in. She wouldn't go away.
She made my knees shake, that little piece of garbage.
She came in, and, yeah, what a fine ass.
Think she's pretty?
Oh, she is beautifully ugly. Like, it's like she's so pretty and ugly put together that she's dynamic. Like, she's just a dynamic little filth ball.
Yeah.
Would you let her sit on your face and put her high on your face?
Why would you even ask that?
I mean, you might be in a faithful vibe now and not
looking. Two girls, one Patrice's face.
Yeah, you were really digging her, man.
She made my knees shake. She really did. That was the second horniest time I've ever had in my life.
Because it was a whole slow talk her into taking her pants off thing.
And then she covered her little twat with her hands.
Yeah.
Did you see it at all?
No, she covered it. Like, she pulled them down and then covered them with her hands, and you just see this small, meaty ass. And that, I think she was the second. I mean, I've been horny, but I mean, where you go, oh, God, you gotta put your face in ice cold water. And the first horniest time ever, like, where, you ever been rapey?
Yes. Rapey?
Yes. Like, where you just go, God, help me not rape.
Yep.
And it was this fucking beautiful girl. In England, she walked out of a club. She was a model, had to be staggering out of a club and just pulled her pants down, squatted and pissed in the middle of the street, and stood back up and walked away. I almost fainted in the gutter. I almost passed out.
Was it the animalistic thing about the whole thing?
It was so. I jerked off 7 times and it still didn't
take care of the
it didn't get the evil out. I just had to sleep.
What the fuck is so like
like the wolf man, you know, the wolf man locks himself in.
Yeah Don't no matter what you hear, don't open this door.
I had to get somebody a gun. If I come out of this room, shoot me. And this Brazilian girl had to be, just in terms of to hit me in terms of horniness, in the top. It had to be a second. She was such a little hot thing with that, just that, I don't know, I don't want to say ugly, because that's so...
No, she's not ugly. She's very pretty.
Ugly is not the word. It's like she's just a strange-looking little sexy thing.
There's something called funny-looking cute.
That's what she is.
That is...
Yes.
That can sometimes surpass hot.
Because she's hot, yes. But she's oddly beautiful. Yeah, I know.
Yes,
she is.
That's
not even oddly beautiful. Oddly beautiful falls into the category,
about,
but
right.
There's funny looking cute, which is a weird thing. Like on first inspection,
I think Charlize Theron.
Yeah.
Is that face?
Really?
Face
what?
Of, yeah, I
no,
think she's like
just,
you go.
She's pretty hot.
She's
man.
Considered like hot and beautiful and classically beautiful.
She's
kind
not.
Of shit.
She, if you look at her, you know. Wait, how about Ashley Judd?
I consider them
like
twins. They're interchangeable, the two of them.
This girl, that's this Brazilian girl. That
I'm trying to think of a good example of funny looking.
I don't know.
Cute.
If she squeezed your cock, you think you would have come? If she would have tugged it a little bit?
I ignored her. I did that fake ignore her.
Oh shit! I didn't have
the mic
on.
She was so cute. I had to fake ignore her. Like I had to be above how cute she was. Like there's something when she pulled her little pants down and that small meaty booty, you could see the meat. You could see how it was a meaty little booty, and she covered her twat up with her hand. It made me sick. My stomach was turning. Like, I was like, oh, you fucking dirty.
You were just,
like, I would risk my relationship if my girl listened to the radio and just stick my face right in that asshole.
Really?
Because that's how I am now. Immediately, it's asshole. Like, if I see a beautiful girl, it's no more pussy. I'm just...
You're
it's
going right.
Asshole. I want to put my face right in her asshole. There's no more vagina.
The vagina has too much humanity attached to it.
Yeah. You just want the filthiest of holes.
Just wherever the stinkiest mess is.
Well, that's where your face
where
is
going. Where are you going to go from asshole, though?
Internal
matter,
organs.
Back his face.
Yeah.
Trach hole.
Just in case she wakes up, I always go
right
for
the
dirtiest.
Trach hole.
I always go for the dirtiest just in case she comes out of her her whatever her coma-like state
the
is that made me want to let me...
Yeah.
Like, fuck with her. I go yeah. daddy first, and then I go, okay, I'll do the regular stuff, but I'm going straight to fucking...
Wow, man.
Yeah, that girl, that particular girl, straight to asshole.
Yeah.
Straight. Not even a smell test.
That's interesting.
She could have wrestled an alligator and came from roller skating at the same time.
That's true. There are, like... certain, and I guess that's what you rapey when you say rapey.
I had a hitchhiker.
You're feeling rapey.
But, yeah, like I don't see. That's what I'm saying. But you know how people take shit out of context. Oh my god! It's like you feel like, oh my god, nothing can soothe what just happened to me.
You should say, yeah, you feel like a caveman.
Well,
what does that mean? Hitting a bitch with a log and dragging her by her hand?
Yes.
Well, you might as well update it to rapey.
I know, but saying I feel like a caveman will save you and you'll get the next Chris Rock project, you idiot.
But you,
I'm just trying to help you out still.
But you know,
you go animalistic. Just go down to that real primal
She still didn't beat that fucking girl, that white girl in England that just squatted.
That squatted and pissed?
And took a laser beam piss. Like, you can
hit, like a plasma cutter cutting
like
through some
metal. Like
a fucking
lifesaver it was coming out. Like, it was straight and then and it didn't curve until she stopped. Like, it just... And she just looking straight ahead and got up and then staggered away almost like some weird nightmare.
Was it the animalistic thing about, what was it about that scene that stood out and made it so hot?
I talked to fucking Norton about it years ago because to this day, it made me crazy. He just goes, it's a naughtiness, I guess. And that's why two girls, one cup, it just didn't bother me. I enjoy seeing beautiful women just do, it makes me feel better about myself. It just when you see a beautiful woman in the street, you just think to yourself, two girls, one cup. Because you just go, this is the reason why men hate women, is that video. It's just like, you mean I'm doing all of this, man? All of this I'm doing to find out that you shit in a cup? I'm doing all of this? Really? Are you serious?
I don't think all women have the capacity to do the two girl, one cup.
That's what they should be doing. I'm trying to succeed in the business world. Grab a cup and make a movie, you fucking hunters.
It just didn't bother me when I saw that thing. It just because I understood there's a psychology behind it, and it was just like, oh. And that girl, they will. If you seen those girls walking on the street, you'll go, oh my god. The one girl had legs like a superhero, man. She had legs like you draw in a comic book, Wonder Woman superhero legs.
Yeah.
And she's just sitting there, sticking her whole hand down her throat, throwing up on another broad. And that itself is disgusting, but the context of it. It's beautiful. It's just it helps men not do bad things. Just to see this girl open her ass and shit
whacked.
In a cup.
No, he's right. I one time, years ago, picked up this hitchhiker. She needed beer money. I was 19. She was maybe 30.
Doesn't start
30.
Well.
I was 19. She was like 30.
Wait a minute, you didn't kill a girl.
Oh, no. No. But she needed beer money. So I bought her a couple of six packs, and we were talking. And she was flirting with me, and she looked at my, I was so horny, and she looked at my cock through my jeans, I had a hard on, and she's like, nah, I can't do anything, I gotta go home, and she's like, nah, it really looks nice, and she squeezed it a little bit through my jeans, she's like, oh, you got a nice cock, and I understood what it would be like to attack somebody. I felt, exactly, that's a great word Patrice had, rapey, I could have raped her, but it wasn't the violence of rape, it was the sexual angle of when someone sexually assaults you.
Right, it wasn't like
hurting her.
Power over you. It was just like,
please let me come.
I can't have you.
Please let me come.
Hey, laser beam piss girl, can I please fuck you, please? And you just know it's not going to happen. And you just go.
If she pissed and then had bent over the cup, and then bent over the car, and then put her ass out and said, come wipe me, would you have come and put your mouth on a pussy?
I'd have did the Puerto Rican cross over my body. I'd have did the Catholic cross and just said, God, I wouldn't know. Like, now, there's nothing that a girl could do filthy that would make me go, like, if a girl, I would know what to do, come wipe my ass. No problem. that ass down to the vagina. I know how to do that, baby girl. Or ass, or no, vagina up to
clit,
ass.
Clit to fucking spine, back just, to clit.
I would know how to do it. Like, I know how to choke chicks and shit. I know how to, I know how to do anything,
you know, all
I
the
need
filth.
To do. Yeah, like, people go, I talk to a girl about spitting in the face, and they just like, ooh, but I know how to do it. It's there's just, I no, know how to do it.
There's no more uncharted territory for you. You are fucking, you've mapped out the entire world
nothing,
of perversity.
Nothing trips me out.
And there's no new land for you, no
I,
new frontier
I know
of
what
filth.
I don't like. I don't like human shit. Is despicable. See, the thing I can watch that two girls thing is because there's no smell. Human shit is just horrid.
Yeah.
So I know
well,
I'm not
we
into
know.
That.
We smelled it yesterday.
It's just holy
shit.
And I'm not into that. And I'm also not into being tied up. But I'll tie a bitch up in a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll tie a chick
hey,
up.
Can
in
I
minute.
Stop wait, it? Wait, like, though, we didn't get to the end of Jim's story. Why didn't she blow you?
She said she had a guy she couldn't, a boyfriend, and she's like, yeah, I just can't. And I knew she wouldn't. I understood that the encounter was over unless I did something bad. So I just dropped her off and
that's how
away.
You knew it was the end, because you can feel right when you get rapey, is that it? What the rapey part was.
That you ain't
oh,
getting it.
Oh, it looks so juicy, but I can't. And you just start shaking.
Because you know she won't. I didn't
you
have,
never felt rapey in your life?
No, I never had it put in that context.
All right,
there
put it
have been,
of,
there have been
of,
you know, dry humping nights. That just, you know, you leave with blue balls and fucking looks like you rubbed your dick on a cheese grater all night. That would, you start feeling rapey.
You ever ask a girl, please? Have you ever said please for pussy?
I don't think I've ever said please.
In your life, have you ever said please?
No.
I beg of you.
Please, no, please.
You don't understand. I've never done the typical guy lines of like, you know, you don't understand, I need this. And, oh, if you were into me, we'd do this. Or if you're, you know, any of that bullshit.
Well, if you start losing your... See, what happened is I start losing this thing where jerking off was being defeated. As soon as I discovered how much I enjoy jerking off,
yeah,
and how little pussy did mean, like the act of it and sticking it in is not as big as like I'll jerk off in fucking a second if a bitch plays the pussy game. But like I said, the ones that fucked me up, like that Brazilian girl, jerking off probably wouldn't have. I ignored her at the end of the day. Like I just got her out my head because jerking off wouldn't have helped. With this little thing just covering her twat with her hand.
Right, right.
I had a massage therapist one time rubbing me, and she had a pair of, like, loose cloth shorts on. She was kind of getting a little nasty, and I'm on my back, and I asked her, I wanted to feel her ass.
Right.
So I asked her to put her ass by my face, so she straddled my face, and when she opened her legs, the cloth part of her shorts came aside, and I saw her pussy lips. And they were fucking fat and massive. It looked like... You ever see a caricature where the fucking head is so much bigger than it looked like a caricature pussy. It didn't look like a human.
And how horny were you?
I can't describe the. I wanted to bite. I wanted to devour her somehow. Like I was that excited. I wound up giving her $600 because I got so crazy.
Wow.
She wouldn't do anything. She wouldn't let me lick it. I didn't know how to play at that time.
You just gave her $600 and with a wink, like
no.
Come on, you know it's just all about.
I kept giving her money, and she was so good at the game that I wound up getting nothing. And I wound up jerking off.
In front of her?
What was the when she left.
Holy shit, you gave her $600
bucks? Did it ever get past just taking a peek?
Eventually, I fucked her. Not that night, but eventually, I fucked her.
Was it as good as the build-up? Like, was it as good as this story?
And now that girl is my wife.
That's right. No, she, I saw
her. So I married her.
That's years ago. I saw her a lot of times after that. And eventually I started licking that big, beautiful, meaty, fat pussy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Was the build-up worth all?
Yeah, it was huge.
Was the payoff?
Big pussy. That was a big, fat pussy, man. Right it on. Drove me... It was visceral.
I think, see, that's the
big
odd
bulge,
thing. Like,
big fat bulge.
I think Jimmy still has that thing with the filth or whatever he's into that you kind of lost. You don't seem to really get excitement anymore.
We have to go
out of it.
Gotta
it's like
go
a
back,
chore.
Got to go back to the day he came in here with his glass dildos.
And
we had a moment. Remember the moment with the glass dildos
and he looked at me
you?
And just was like,
what are you doing?
Are you all right, man?
Yeah.
And something did happen to me at that time. Like, the other day,
I was trying to, you know, we were trying to hook back up with that little threesome, and
all right,
and she got girly. I don't know what happened, but she's not. She just disappeared. So I, you know,
wow, that's an update.
Yeah, she just like.
What, did Jimmy hear about that? The ultimate threesome he got for his birthday?
Oh yeah, the threesome I had for my birthday.
No, I didn't hear about that. And you were trying to get that to happen again, and now here's the
and the update.
Who's she? Your girl or the other girl?
My girl. Well, you know, you got to have your girl do it. So I'm talking to my girl to talk to her, and she just won't call my girl back. But this girl was a soldier.
That
just
good.
A fucking.
How'd you know her? Was she?
I met her. I just met her, and then talked to her about my birthday, and talked to her, and then she just ended up being a bisexual. Took her home one night, and it was the best threesome I ever had, and we didn't even fuck her. Like, she was on a period. We didn't even fuck her. She was a tremendous. Because the thing that made it tremendous is she fucked me. She fucked us.
Yeah.
She didn't fuck
nice.
Me, and then she didn't fuck. She just, wherever there was an opening, she would go, okay, I'll go there. She just hovered. She was a perfect threesome girl because she just hovered anywhere she can be in.
Yeah.
She would go there. Oh, there's a spot there under your arm. There's her titty, and there's your elbow. I'm going to get right in that motherfucker right there. And she just...
Did your girl like it?
Yeah, she likes it, but she gets a little... she saw what a little tramp this girl was, and her mind couldn't just be free. Because this girl was licking my girl's ass, and I was licking my girl's pussy. And my girl, I go, how can you not enjoy it? Because she's just sitting there. And then me and the girl did some weird... I couldn't even help it. This is the thing where you could... We were kissing... And eating my girl's pussy at the same time. I couldn't pass up. Relationship or tongue kiss this girl and eat my girl's pussy at the same time. Take the tongue kiss. Fuck it.
Girlfriends are replaceable. Jesus. That scenario is not.
I don't want to speculate because I never asked why, but I don't know what the fuck. It causes me pain that she disappeared.
Yeah, huh?
But at least you had it once, though.
Oh, that's she came through like an animal.
Speaking of which,
wow, it sounded like it was going to be one of those things that you might revisit.
This is what I fucking girls are so fucking their assholes. No guy would go. I go, sweetie, why wouldn't you want to get your asshole?
A guy would be waiting by the phone for it to ring.
Here's the thing: she jilted us. This is what happened.
Jilted.
And she was supposed to come out one Friday, and what happened is. I had everything planned out. I went into my old. I have a trunk in the house.
Oh shit!
And it's it's like the GIMP trunk. You know, you go in there and there's some shit in there. And I was dusting off shit like I ain't shit.
Oh
you shit.
Wow!
Because you know you fuck your girl. Your girl's not an object no more. You know, she's not really an object like she used to be. She's my girl. She's not taboo. I just go, take your goddamn clothes off, asshole. And she goes, eat my pussy, nigga. You know, that's...
You were, my
I want my
talk.
Pussy, motherfucker.
You were bringing stuff out of retirement.
Yeah, I was...
Dusting it off.
I had it all laid out. I got
hello,
this,
old friend.
Like this long black thing, like the bondage shit and all that, because this girl was into just all type of shit. I had a mask to put on her fucking head and all
wow.
that.
Wow.
So I was.
You were gonna.
Yeah, we was gonna fucking really.
That's what happened. You planned it out too much, got all worked up and frothy. Then you forgot. You got fucked.
You got the.
That's how mad I was.
You
right?
got the carrot top trunk of sex toys, man. I want to know what else is in this thing.
I tried to do it. I gotta say, I love my girl for being this much of a trooper. I tried to replace what I was gonna do just with her. But I tied her up and was trying to work with me to be as, she was
really?
Being extra dirty.
Yeah.
And I just go.
She gave it the old Collins try for you.
Wait a minute. Are you sure?
I'm so sweetie, I love you, but I don't want you. I want to choke this new bitch.
I don't want this call to go away. We got Tim in Kentucky. Tim, go ahead.
Shit.
Now, Colin, the phrase of the year has to come from Patrice's three-way there, where he said last time that she was fighting for dick space.
Fighting for dick space.
Right, the girl, because the girl, what happened is the my girl, when she came out the bathroom, I just go, sweetie, come out the bathroom with no clothes on. And the other girl, I go, look, take your clothes off. She's like, are you, and she would, I don't understand how she could not come back because she was just so perfect. She goes, is she going to be mad if I'm naked when you come out? I go, bitch. Take that off. She takes it off just like a soldier. My girl comes out naked. She comes out, sits down. My girl pulls my dick out. This chick pops right on my dick like, I was saying, like, you ever see Darkman when they killed him? And that and that fucking bird that that bird that hit the lighter to blow Darkman up? That's how fucking she went down on my dick. And she's sucking it, and my girl is looking at this girl. She's looking at this girl going, we look at each other going, oh, shit, because we've done a few threesomes, but this bitch was a soul. And we look at each other, and my girl's like, well, fuck that. This young piece of garbage ain't coming in and taking my title. So she just goes down. She starts looking at my balls. So this girl's looking at my dick, and the other girl's looking at my balls. And then the girl kind of stops to go, no, I'm not, I don't want to fight you for dick space. I'll just go behind you, sweetie, and lick your asshole. And my girl's sucking my dick going, oh, my God, what have I done? Because I'm sitting there like, yes!
Were you playing with your nipples?
Jimmy. I tried to
Jimmy,
be...
Jimmy, you touching yourself, by the way?
I tried to be as dirty...
I'm almost filled up.
I tried to be as dirty as possible, but at the same time, I'm trying to not piss my girl off.
Yeah, of course, of course.
So I'm kind of enjoying it. But then I said, fuck that, I have to enjoy this. Because that's when the kissing came in, was just, the kissing is what happened. Because this chick, for a girl to be that submissive to lick your girl's asshole, and then we're just both on her twat, but she's licking her asshole and I'm licking her twat, then we reverse, and then we're both on her twat, and my girl's just sitting there going, she's going to take my man. Not enjoying two people licking, that's what...
You and her were bonding over your girl's pussy.
Oh.
You were bonding over it. Do you think that your girl
scream
really
again, Patrice. Yeah, it's okay. They feel your pain out there.
Oh, God damn. And she just, I don't know, she just gone now.
You think she really, your girl really called her? Or do you think that your girl...
Nah, been, she, no, she, did? She, no, she, my girlfriend, God damn it, God love her, she, when it comes to this shit, she might have her little problems after, or she gets girly, but she is a fucking trooper. I've seen her in action. She don't fuck around. And that's why I don't go to swing clubs anymore, by the way.
Why?
Because I bring a goddamn gunslinger. Doc Holliday, baby. When I go to a motherfucking swing club, I bring Doc Holliday with me. What? You want me to kill who, sweetie? This motherfucker and that motherfucker. What's that shit from Tombstone? I'll be your Huckleberry. That's my girl. And these motherfuckers come there with this plan to take Fat Boy's girl and not let me touch his girl. I'm like, nah.
Really? Man. Oh, you've had that?
Nah. Huh?
You've had that?
Oh yeah, we swung, man, and we our first swinging experience was good. The third one is like guys are trying to figure out how to fuck my girl and his girl and push me out. I never do that.
How'd you try to push you out?
By kind of fucking with his girl and like trying to ignore me, and my girl's looking at me and I'm looking at him like, you don't even know, motherfucker. Like, why are you fucking up the etiquette? I bring a soldier and you playing around trying to be a pimp, you fucking idiot. You can't be a pimp at a swing club. This is a lifestyle, you asshole. You trying to take my girl? Go ahead, do your thing. My girl get up and
what'd you do?
Nothing. Just I get up, I sit there and I let him think he's gonna. And he's all rough and all fucked up. But the best way to do it is like, you go, the first time I did it, the dude was very, very gentle with my chick, and she liked him. And I'm like, good, because I'm going to be very gentle with his chick.
I don't get that. And I couldn't sit by and watch that shit.
So wait, the third guy was fucking trying to...
Bizarre.
He was just trying to get a threesome at my expense. And yeah. He don't know, I trained a goddamn specialist.
How did that happen?
She's special ops.
She's special ops, and she's not fucking going around. She's not gonna. She's not a traitor. She's not gonna give up government secrets.
How did it end?
What? He left because I had to explain to him, dude. You know, stop trying to be a pimp.
Did you say that?
Yeah.
Good.
Stop trying to be smooth, stupid. It's like guys that go to Brazil and try to be a pimp. What, are you an asshole? It's a world of hookers. Don't stop. This is where you're. You cannot have to be cool.
Are you worried your girl will leave you for one of these guys?
Nah.
Not at all?
Not even
a little bit? Come on.
Not even a little bit.
Let's get that hard shell. Let's get inside that hard shell a little bit. Chris Rock started this today.
I'm going to be as humble as I possibly can.
Not at all. Go ahead,
it's
sorry.
It's only because if you find a woman, this is the thing why you have to filth your girl out and let her be free as possible. I let my girl know, I have long conversations with her. Giving away pussy for a woman is so unfulfilling. Going to get other dick is not even cheating on you. It's like, your woman can go and go fuck 20 guys. It's unfulfilling. The difference is, I'm chasing pussy. I'm trying to get that real estate. She's giving real estate away. So if she sees some other dude with a better dick, fuck the shit out of her, sweetie. Go ahead, get her, tiger. Fuck her. Then one day she's going to be sitting there and become a girl. What's this all about? Then she got to come see me, and I'll tell you what it's all about, bitch. You're goofy. I tell a bitch she's goofy.
You're insane, man.
You think that's what happened with
Drew? You're not on.
Okay. You think that's what happened with your new threesome girl?
Something she got goofy girly and went after happened. Some
guy? Yeah.
She probably has a boyfriend. She probably probably was like addicted to something that she didn't want to be a dick girl. Because girls run from shit that makes them feel good. This is just, well, and especially if they're driven. It's like, this will make me fail math, so I can't. You dumb bitch, eat a ball, bitch. Put this ball in your mouth.
What happens when you call the guy a pimp? You told the guy stop being a pimp. Yeah. What happened? I never heard that.
He got his girl. He said, yo, all right, man, I'm out. You know, because he was trying to pimp my girl. He's trying to whisper in her ear. And his girl, here's the fucking thing. I'm being very, like, soft with his girl. See, this is the thing. Giant dick man can't beat me. I'll find a place.
Giant dick man.
Like,
did he have a giant dick?
I think he did, because he pulled out like half of it. He didn't even pull it all out, and it was bigger than my dick, so that, yeah, he's a giant dick. So it's like you, what happens is he's trying to go, blah, 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 and I'm trying to touch his girl, and he trained her not to be a soldier. You understand? He trained her to play a motherfucker out. I train my girl, you get more if you sell that motherfucker the dream he's looking for. Go get him, tiger!
What was his girl doing while you were touching her?
She looking at him, and they were trying to, and I would just sit back, and I'll go, I don't even need to look at my girl, because the only thing she looks for is if a guy's hurting her, like, meaning, you know, he's, the motherfucker's getting too crazy, squeezing the tits too hard, and, and you go, and then she goes, and you gotta go, dude, you see she's not really, you know.
She's not into that.
Does it make you angry?
He's like, yo, nah, hey, I don't get, you don't get crazy.
Aren't you bringing the hottest girl into those places too?
My girl would
be. Your girl
be,
is hot, man. She's, she's a looker.
I'm imagining
there's a lot of
down.
Messes in those places.
There'll be a lot of old white couples that you want to just drop kick, but it's like, I bring our property value down, like in terms of hot couple. Like, you know, if you see on the internet, hot couple 26. It's like, I'm not part of that. My girl is the selling point of that game, but I walk her through it. And the thing is, you talk about girls leaving. Who the fuck is she going to leave me for? And this is not an arrogant statement. Who the fuck is she going to leave me for that would allow her to pee on a motherfucker, swing, eat some other pussy, spit in a nigga's face? Who the fuck is she going to go do that with? And it's the same thing. Who the fuck? I got to go retrain a bitch? I'm a general. I can't. My girl is a lieutenant. I don't want to go back to basic training and go try to talk some bitch through having a threesome and convince her why it's good.
Wow. Let's go to John in Missouri. John, what's
you
up?
You are in deep then.
Johnny.
A lot Hello? Invested.
Hey.
Hey, this is Todd.
Oh, okay.
Whatever.
Todd from Missouri, what's up?
Just you, sir.
Hey, Patrice brings up a lot of good points. My wife and I, we're in the lifestyle. And Opie,
I love that. We're in the lifestyle.
It's a lifestyle.
We're in the lifestyle.
It is a lifestyle. Please, respect it.
All right.
It's such a vague thing for we like fucking other
and
people.
And why the fuck, well, excuse me, dude, before you finish this, why is being gay more acceptable in this fucking country than swinging?
Because you got to get a political, like, party together or something. You got to get politically active
That's
with this
true.
Lifestyle.
Why is
Excellent
too-
point.
You Thank you.
You don't have all the swinging American people fighting.
Right, right.
That's all it is.
You got to get your parade going. There's
a
lot
preference.
Of things you got to do.
I was born this way.
Oh.
I want insurance.
I don't think that's going to wash.
I want health insurance.
Part of benefits.
Because I like sleeping with two bitches.
Part of benefits for my five friends.
Todd.
Sorry, man.
Go ahead, Todd.
No, that's all right. Anyways, Opie, you had said something about, aren't you worried about your girl leaving you? I think a lot of people that you know, don't practice this kind of a lifestyle don't realize that it's not about, you know, feelings, and it's not about worrying about, you know, if your spouse or your girl is going to leave you. It's just about sex, and that's all it is. It's sex.
I couldn't
and I,
do it.
I think I get turned on by her so much more after we do that shit. I love my girl again. Like, sometimes you just get that. Like, I always say about, like, men, like, you ever been with a man, like, ladies that been with a man, and
have you ever been with a man?
Well, like, I'm just not talking to women, really. And, you know, and women, ask that woman, is she be with a guy, and she goes, this motherfucker acts like he on his period. Like, he's acting like I act monthly. Mm. But what that is men have a period, and it's called being faithful for long periods of time. If you don't get side pussy for a long time, you get the same, like, symptoms as a bitch on a period. You get sick, you get nauseous, you get fucked, you gotta take pills.
You found something here. You really gotta write a book and throw all this in a book. I'm telling you. It'd be a great read.
I would do
it. Because you're, like, you think, like,
no one else I've ever heard in my life is what he thinks like.
She gets turned. I just attach myself to my feelings and I understand it. It's just like she gets so much. I forget how sad. Like, I didn't have to ruin my relationship to get different pussy. That's what a three is, man.
This is your thing, though. Go get a book deal. I'm telling you.
I can hazard a guess as to why Patrice's girl won't leave him. Because, and tell me if I'm wrong. Because, you know, she's with a general now. If she leaves you, she might find out that the next guy is a cadet.
He's right.
And then she has to train him, and she don't want to do that.
I have to tell her all the time, fight them, don't fight me. You understand? Fight the, like, after a while, a karate instructor, he don't instruct his best fucking student no more. That student instructs others. And that the best student comes and gets a cut. Like, I was like, bitch, stop trying to fight me all the time. Go out there and go get him.
Wait, have you ever seen your, this is what would bother me. Like, have you ever watched your girl? Because me and Florentine one time years ago picked up two girls.
Yeah.
And I couldn't get an erection. I was laying there humiliated. And Jim was fucking this girl well. He was fucking her brains out.
God, he
out.
Has great fuck stories.
Florentine was fucking this girl like a professional. And I thought to myself, if you ever let him fuck your girlfriend, you're finished.
I've seen
because
it.
Because then she'll see me afterwards and feel like, ugh.
I've seen it, dude. You're back to your floundering. I've seen a guy with better prowess than me going at it. And
with your girl?
And she attaches. Girls don't go, I need more dick. I want all kinds of dick. They pretend they do by calling it nymphomania and all. But they don't. Girls want to fuck one guy a lot. They don't want to fuck a lot of guys once. We want to fuck a lot of women once. And every woman.
Getting some reactions out there, my friend.
Girls don't go, give me more dick. Because there's no challenge to a bitch just saying, fuck me, here's pussy. It's not, it's nothing to them.
You're saying because there'd be a line just waiting to get in there.
Well, who's she going to get? My girl's going to get revenge on me by giving away her fucking twat? Good luck to you.
Hey,
low self-esteem. It's not going to fucking happen.
No, we should do. We got a huge audience today on the bleachers. Anybody have a question for Patrice? And his ways of thinking. Anybody in a situation, they need a little advice?
God, you're on line one.
Right. Anybody out there want to ask Patrice a question about relationships, sex
in
general?
It's just not even...
But you just have a way about you when it comes to this stuff.
Just,
yeah,
I'm,
let's see if anybody's got anything. Anybody?
They call it misogyny, but it's just not. It, girls just don't want to be with a guy that they have to run.
Well, let's see. Mm. Anybody want
to... Yeah, you're putting them on the spot. They might have to think about the questions a little bit.
We got a couple. You could use a fake name or whatever. We don't give a shit. Here's a young lad.
Patrice, how you doing, mate?
How are you? First of all, your problem is you're not circumcised.
Correct. Hey, he's our friend from down under.
Yeah, man.
You do the walkover like once, twice a year, right?
Yeah, just got here yesterday.
You're back in the States again. I remember you.
Yeah, man.
What's
I was
going
to ask Patrice, how do you bring up eating asshole with your girlfriend? How do you just
you don't bring
that
up nothing.
Her?
There's no way you can ask your girl to do anything sexual, and she goes, "Okay, practice saying to yourself, hey, can I lick your asshole?" She has to say fucking no. So what you do is you just do assholey things. First of all, any bitch who doesn't want her asshole licked is an asshole. Like, that's not fucking her in the ass. Licking her ass is such a pleasurable thing, you just do it. That's one of those things you just do.
Yeah, but these are average guys. They don't have the game like you, so you gotta give something.
When you're eating a pussy, eat a pussy from behind, doggy style, and stick your face in it, and do assholey things. Like, if you're licking a pussy from doggy style,
things.
Have your nose near her asshole breathing hot air, nose air on her asshole, and she'll feel, and then she'll just want something. It's just like how you get the girl to spit. You just introduce spitting somehow. Like, you tell her, oh, just spit on it. And she'll do the girl tooey, but you just, spit now exists. It's there. So you do things around her asshole, and then asshole is in the picture. How do you do anything without asshole being in the picture anyway? If you're fucking with the pussy, that's your fault.
So you just got to introduce it into your life.
Like, you just do
maybe
it.
Turn all the chairs in your apartment upside down.
Just
something.
Eat a lot of mushrooms.
just somehow introduce it into
you
your
ask them. They can't.
Day-to-day life.
No girl can. They want to be tricked into being whores. You cannot ask a girl, can I do anything? Because first of all, she's gonna go, this fucking faggot asking me shit. Asking, can I? No, that's like pulling a hair. It has to be animal. Because half the shit all a girl would do up to her is lay on her back. This is another reason why my girl, and again, I don't want to say this in that because she can leave, but she's like, some guy goes, can I pull your hair, beautiful? She'll go, you faggot motherfucker. Punch me in the face. She would have to get, because see, as a man, I can get any woman to do anything disgusting. Because that's my thing. My thing is manipulation. Girls cannot figure out a way to get a guy to lick her asshole when her ex-boyfriend did it. She got no, there's no technique to going, listen, my ex-boyfriend used to, like, shove his balls in my mouth so I couldn't breathe. Is it possible you can do that, uncircumcised cock?
All right. Anybody else have a question out there? Anybody else brave enough to ask Patrice a sex question? Nope. Here we go.
What's up, guys?
Hi.
Well, Patrice, my girlfriend hasn't gone down on me in like 3 years. How do I get her to start doing it again?
You really?
Oh, it, boy. First of all, let the audience laugh at you.
Wow.
It is Point of Laugh Friday, so here's a great opportunity.
You want her to suck your dick? Make her convert from Judaism.
You know what it is? Without just saying fucking leave her, what you do is you step your sex game up to such a level and don't ask for nothing from her, she'll get competitive because she'll go, I don't want him to leave me and go do these things he's doing to me to some other broad. What you do is have an ethic about how you make her come without asking anything. So you eat a pussy, whatever she do, you make her lose her mind and then go, nope, that's fine. Like, you jerk off. Like, after you take care of her, you beat off or something, and she'll go, you don't want me to do any? Nah, don't worry about it. And she'll get competitive, and then she'll start sucking your dick.
Thank you, Patrice.
All right, let's go to the phones. Melanie in Philly. Melanie!
Hey. Hey. I know that you're taking audience questions, so I have a question for Patrice. I don't mind that a guy goes down and eats my asshole, but there's a difference between him going down and eating my pussy and then kissing me and then eating my asshole and kissing me. I can't handle that.
So yeah, because you're saying that you're not handling it because that's what you're supposed to say. But
when you go down there, it's all holds bar. When you're feeling good and you're moaning, you're running, that's great.
Is it anything wrong with your asshole, ma'am?
There's nothing
dirty about the hole itself. It's the inside. I'm not licking your lower intestines, bitch. I'm licking your clean asshole.
You just lick my asshole and you want me to, like, kiss you.
Yes.
How do you do that?
Yes. Do you clean your booty hole?
Yes.
Then what the fuck is the problem?
Because
it's the same thing as a twat. Like, the pussy is infinitely nastier than the fucking asshole. Than the actual knot, the balloon knot is not. It should be clean as a whistle.
This is where the difference between man versus woman comes.
Exactly, that's the problem. That's why women should just not be allowed to ever discuss two things in terms of being a professional: fucking
speaking
and funny.
Speaking?
Being funny. What? And having sex. You're not allowed to have your own idea about sex because you don't know. Because let me ask you a question. Isn't there something?
No, you're doing it to us, though. We should be able to have some kind of say in that.
You know what?
No,
I don't like the
you
fact
shouldn't.
That she sounds like Jimmy's mom.
She asked the same type of questions.
Can I ask you a quick question, real quick, ma'am? How many times have you said to yourself, like, think about when you was younger and you just started fucking, where you go,
I'll never do that. And now you do that.
She's gone.
Hello?
She's gone.
Oh,
sorry about that.
Women just should.
I don't know where she went.
We got
Troy from Pennsylvania. Troy.
Hey, Patrice.
Shut up.
You hear me?
I love him.
Hey, Patrice, you there?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, hey, Patrice. I've been married for 17 years, and I married my wife. She was 19, really hot. And now, after 17 years, she's got about 40 extra pounds. How can I get her to just kind of ease out all that weight, man, without just saying, look, you repulse me. I do not want to touch you. How can I do that, man?
You step your game up to such a high level, right? Like, my girl, she look good. Sometimes I get lazy, and you stop dressing nice. What you do is you start putting on your I'm going to get another bitch attitude on. Without telling her. You don't say, hey, get your shit together. You wear a top hat and a tuxedo now when you go to the store. And that bitch will go, oh, my God. And you'll see that bitch on the treadmill tomorrow. Trust me.
Wait, or a simpler solution, sir, if that doesn't work, is on the screensaver, you get a scrolling screensaver that just says, fat cunt.
I want to try that. I need to do something, man, because I tell you what, she's like your soldier. She wants to go every night, and it just makes me sick, man. Sick.
Wow.
Sick. Yeah, she does.
You're in a fucked up place.
He's unattractive. First of all, he's already used to her. And now she's becoming a little unattractive. You just got to put on your... First of all, I tell my girl all the time, she sees me talking to girls. I say, look, you know how I'm attracted to you? You're an object. You're physically. You know why you're attracted to me? Because I know how to fucking talk and make things sound sexy. How the fuck am I going to do that when you don't want to hear that bullshit from me no more? I got to go do it to other bitches. If other bitches don't want to fuck me, how you going to want to fuck me? So you got to go out and be super fuckable, and she will step up her shit. Trust me, because you sound like a depressed dude who's sinking down further into her world, which is like, ugh.
And you know what, Patrice? I'm not a bad-looking guy. I work out. I'm really fit. And I could go out and do better physically. I mean, we got kids together, and I do love her. But everywhere I go, I have no problem meeting women. And I just look at her, and I look at this nice young woman that's flirting with me, and I just, damn, I could just move her right on.
That's right. But don't threaten her with it. Just let it happen. Just okay. It's happening. And you know what, dude? Don't be such a pussy. Go get some side. Don't tell nobody. Get some side, dude. Get some side pussy. Like, don't be such a fucking... Don't be so... This is going to destroy... Go get some dirty girl and do that. And your wife will go, why doesn't he give a shit about me? Just don't tell her. Give her kisses. Mwah, I love you so much, sweetie. Because she innately fucking knows. That's what women do. They try to make their men unsexy. That's the plan. They're the enemy. They come in and find a man that's the shit. And then they try to bring them down and make them feel good about themselves. That's why I say, if your bitch don't hate you, you're not in a good relationship. My bitch hates how much she loves me. She has to. She wants to be equal with me. No, you're not. I'm better than you. And her whole journey is to destroy my life. All you gotta do is stop it from happening. Your wife is succeeding in destroying your life by becoming fat. It's a plan.
Patrice is the really last king of Scotland.
Holy shit.
That's really good. Patrice, you gotta write that book, I'm telling you, buddy. All right, speaking of getting side,
I just gotta interrupt real quick. I gotta leave. I got eye surgery.
What are you talking about?
I hate to leave. I'm really enjoying this. But yeah,
his eyeballs.
Good eyes, baby.
Yeah.
Take care of my eyeballs, sweetie.
I'll be all right.
Where are you going?
I gotta go. I have a 10:30 appointment.
Why?
Because my eyes are not good.
He's gonna get his eyes done.
Yeah.
And let me look at Jimmy with the glasses.
Can I crush your glasses right now?
No, because I'm gonna wear them without the corrective lenses just to make me look gentlemanly. Thanks.
I'm bad with glasses.
Jim Norton.
Distinguish.
I'm a gentleman.
People on the bleachers, the great Jim Norton.
You a little nervous, Jimmy?
Happy New Year, Merry Christmas, young man.
Too, sweetie.
Who's going to the New Year's Eve show with Jim Norton? We got some people out there going?
Wow, good. Overwhelming response.
Ah, well, one person raises their
hand. I'm going.
Two, three. All right, they're raising their hands now.
I'm going.
North Fork Theater, Westbury, New Year's Eve with Jim Norton.
Yes.
Some tickets still available.
I think we have a couple left to give away.
All right. Call up if you want.
No, you're going to kill us.
Hold on.
We got so many great questions on the line. Can't we just give them to a few people out there?
You can do that.
Would that be all right?
That's fine. As long as
I mean, they came
away.
Out last day before the holiday.
Here's the thing.
They should get a chance to win something.
I will see you all there on whatever it was. Fucking
New Year's Eve.
Whatever night it is. I'm going to be blinded.
No!
I'm fucking... All right, listen, I'll see you guys later.
Do they give you drugs?
I have a half a Valium I think I take at the surgery.
Are you worried about feeling drugs?
Not at all.
No?
No.
Not in this case.
No, it's fine.
Are you kind of psyched that you're going to be like feeling drugs?
Not at all.
I always wonder that with, you know, addicts.
No, no.
If you would be like, you know, holy shit, this feels...
Why do you think I'm racing out of here a half hour early?
This feels really good.
I'll see you guys.
All right, Jimmy, good luck. I'll give you a call.
All right, my love.
And it's on. F.H. Riley's after your show.
Yeah, we're going to go over there after it, eat and shit.
Bro's getting some kind of beer special together, and we'll have a good time. So.
Okay, good, man. All right, Patrice.
All right, sweetie, good luck, man.
Jimmy, all right, man. Great year of
radio. Godspeed, yes.
Year of radio.
Godspeed.
The great Jimmy Norton.
Godspeed, my young man. Godspeed.
How about this? We'll take a break. We'll continue with Patrice. We'll get more questions from the audience. We got great... Great questions on hold. If you're on hold, stay there. We'll get you on the air as soon as possible. Threw Boogie in the house. Are you set to roll? Yeah, he is.
Oh,
all
yeah.
Right. We got Patrice O'Neill. I don't want to lose. There's a couple good calls. Ray in Pennsylvania.
Hey, what's going on, boys?
Show's moving fast. What do you got for Patrice O'Neill? You've been waiting a while here.
Hey, Patrice, I have a question for you, man. I've been dating this girl for a month, man. I haven't fucked her yet. I've been playing with the goods, you know, here and there. And the bitch won't leave me alone.
Set it
now,
in.
What do you think? Is she crazy or is she just, I don't know, she's in love with me, I don't know.
See, he's saying is he's so fucking fantastic that the bitch won't leave him alone.
I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. All I know is, you know, people have been telling me that she's kind of crazy and she's hot.
He's fucked a girl and she's a clingy bitch.
The problem is not him. He just told you. I mean, the problem's not her. He just told you what the problem is. First of all, dude, he's calling in to even higher his self-esteem is low. And I'm not even trying to be funny. He goes, guys have warned him that this bitch is crazy. He still fucked with her. He was surprised that he fucked with her because he had to add she was hot just in case.
Uh-huh.
He's not a hot guy. So basically, here's what you should fucking do. You should leave this girl alone and go get a girl that your self-esteem will allow you to deal with. Because you won't even be able to deal with a crazy bitch that's pretty, that's stalking you. He's happy about that. This is what he's saying. I'm getting stalked.
Yeah. He was just calling to brag. That's not a problem.
Someone's stalking me. Dude, and enjoy until you get that fucking rape case.
All right, sir. All right. Anyone have a question out there for Patrice? No one else brave enough? We got one. They're raising their hand.
Who's that?
Hold on. Dan will get you.
Oh. Is it? Oh, great. It's it's Young Flea Man. Young Flea has
You know what? Flea, after every show, like if he comes to a show of mine, Flea will talk to me for an hour and a half about his problems with women.
No shit.
His last problem was he was in love with this old broad, and she left him, and he just was kept pouring his soul out, whatever's whatever
he found
inside.
He found another one at Bar 9.
he fucking stalks old women.
Does he really? That's your thing?
Yeah. Flea chases old women.
No, he was making out with some old broad at Bar 9.
How old was she?
She was actually 38, but the story that Patrice
for
is
him.
Talking about is...
That's old for you.
I know.
You're what, 20?
Yeah. So... But no,
you got a mommy thing or something?
No,
Flea's rhythm is just uncomfortable.
Yeah,
yeah.
He's the kind of guy that gives that old thing where you give a phone number out 21 286.
Yeah, he's got a weird way of talking. I have a question about sex.
Do you? What?
That's.
Well, yeah. My question for Patrice is: how do you get a girl to put out?
Get out of here.
Not a put out.
That's rookie shit.
Yeah, that's
to
like
a put
even...
out. What the fuck is that? That's like junior high shit.
He sounds like Napoleon Dolomite.
Patrice, I want to know, how do I get to first base?
Right, right.
Dude. Where do I put my penis? Well, which hole?
I heard there was a story that perhaps you were your hand was going over a girl's shirt.
Well, it was two nights ago. I brought a girl. She's 18 years old, and I met her thanks to my roommate. And I took her out to dinner once, and we ended up going to park like a couple times to walk around. I brought her back to my room. We ended up, you know, making out on my bed, and I go for a feel outside the shirt, and as I try to go underneath, she said, "No, no, no, I don't want to go any further." So I felt like a shithead, and then it kind of ended awkwardly because she had to leave and study for tests, and I got blue balls, and then I had to jerk off and go to sleep.
Yuck.
So.
All right.
So you're wondering, what you could have done between above the shirt and under the shirt that would have kept her there.
I'm wondering, is there anything in between or something that I should change or do that would
seriously, Flea, like it's a power thing, and you're just so and I'm not even trying to be funny. You're so uncomfortable that you give girls power. Like, you give anybody who talks to you right away, you gave them power. Like, there's nothing about you that says I own my own space. So there's no way you shouldn't be able to fuck an 18-year-old. You should be able to talk your way into some 18-year-old pussy. But you're so giving her little power that's why a woman gets off more telling a guy no that she can control than fucking actually giving up pussy. Women, especially 18-year-old girl, they like men wanting to fuck them. This is the great thing about God. Is that, God. I'm serious, that God has made it so when guys get my age, I look at women my age, 38, 39, 40, and they want to fuck all the time. And you go, get the fuck out of here. And they don't want to play, they just want dick. But women 18, they like to want to be fucked. They just like guys to want to fuck them. And Flea is one of those, Flea, you're never going to learn until you get 40. You're stuck. Because you're the type of, and I'm not even trying to be an asshole, you're the type of dude that makes 18-year-old girls struggle all through their life till they're 38 and they meet me and they find out, oh my God, I've been wasting all my fucking time. Because like I keep saying, the value of pussy is like cars and ain't like houses.
It goes
down.
All right.
Go get some roofies or something,
Flea. Yeah, Flea, you're in deep shit.
Right.
You're in deep shit, Flea.
Yeah, let's say hi to Bob in Michigan. Bob, what's up?
Hey, not much, what do you know?
Hey.
I got a question for Dr. Patrice.
Yeah.
Yeah, hey, my wife, 5 years, wants to do a threesome.
Yeah.
But she's not really too willing in doing the legwork. She wants me to do it, and I've had threesomes in the past.
Dangerous. Don't do it.
The other group.
Don't do it. Never. And if you do, it's very rare. What you do immediately, and just don't be greedy. Get this. Because I do that sometimes where I fucking start the leg because my girl doesn't know. Women hate other women, and they don't know how to fucking keep talking their way into shit. As soon as you get information about this other chick, you give the number to your wife. And then you walk your wife through to this other bitch. The other bitch should never have contact with you. This other threesome girl that dumped us, I'm sitting there like, fuck, because I'm thinking about what I would say. Like, well, hold on, bitch. Wait a minute. What's going on here? I'll talk my way. My girl's not going to talk her way into pussy. They don't like girls enough
and,
like that.
And you would seem a little overeager going to your girl and going, hey, why don't you call her again?
Hey, call a threesome girl. You can't be greedy on this one, dude. Do not go out and get the girls. Your relationship, it'll be over.
Right. Well, at first she said that's what she wanted me to do, but she has to approve. And I'm like, no, no, no. You need to scout. You need to go find what you like. Because, you know, I'm going to be happy with anything. I mean, we go to topless bars, man, and my wife gets so turned on, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, that's a tough thing, man. Girls are just... They really just should leave us to certain things. I'll give them certain things. They can have health, like caring about living and dying and shit. But when it comes to funny and when it comes to fucking, man, just let dudes handle it, man. Let dudes handle it. But they don't understand that shit because I tell my girl, she gets really jealous, but she's... It's like I tell her, I own your jealousy. The only reason your jealousy means something to me is because I go... I give your jealousy power, but I can go, look, I want to fuck this other bitch. What are you going to do? You're either going to leave me or you're going to fucking stay. But I give her the jealousy. I go, look, oh, come on, baby. You're the greatest. But everything you give a bitch, is you give it to them. That's what it is. Motherfuckers, girls get confused that they actually are running shit. They're not. You know, what is it? Five women to every one guy, dude? Five to fucking one? And God put my horniness on earth for me to be with one bitch, and there's four other bitches that got no man. Then you got homosexuals, then you got dead motherfuckers, then you got retarded motherfuckers. I got all their shit. There's 15, 20 women I should be fucking, and I'm not because I love you? Goofy bitch, grow up.
We got Fast Freddy from Jamaica Station. Man. He's got a really good question for you, Patrice. He writes, I have a sincere question for Patrice. He's the only one that can answer this one. How do I get my girl to let me come in her mouth, then spit it in another girl's ass and tell me to fuck it?
That takes years and years. Wow. Training.
That's like the last boss of a real hard game.
Right. Yeah. That's like,
you
yeah.
gotta go find all the cheat codes for that one.
Oh. X up down yeah. square question mark.
You gotta find God mode.
That's tough, man. You can only do that if you're a general.
But you can get that once you fill her out. You get a filthy to that level, but a lot of guys, you know what, learn, like talking to dudes, a lot of dudes are fucking just as square as girls.
All right, hold on, they're directing us today. Stalker Patty's by the microphone. Stalker Patty.
Oh, I have a question for Dr. Patrice. What is somebody my age supposed to do? Every place or whatever I visit to meet guys, they're all half my age, and then everybody I know in person is either married, gay, or dead. Well, what am I supposed to do to meet somebody?
Patty, try harder. Join Patty, the third.
Here's a problem with Patty. When she says, when women like fucking Patty say close. Meet you, she means meet a guy that wants to be with her.
Yeah.
Patty, you gotta give up that messy twat. You gotta fuck a guy first. You're building your house. You gotta build your house from the top to the bottom.
Right.
You fuck the foundation. Start at the on the roof.
What about AIDS and diseases. I'm scared to death.
How much time do you got left to live as a healthy person anyway?
Probably not more than 30 years.
Listen,
maybe.
With all the medicine now, you'll live. If you get AIDS now, you'll live until the time you were supposed to die without AIDS.
Really?
Pretty much.
All right, so say here's so many warnings nowadays.
Oh, shut up. The guy that you would fuck wouldn't have anything, believe me. Don't worry about it. He'd be just like you, some fucking shut-in that hasn't been fucked.
Basically, Patrice is saying there's nothing interesting about you where a guy would want to just hang out with you. You got to give up the pussy.
Your voice would clear out your bad blood cells. As soon as you stop talking, all the AIDS are just, I'm out of here.
Oh,
I can't. Get the fuck
the AIDS virus can't take it.
I'm bored with this body.
She's the cure for AIDS.
Yeah, just talk.
And I shouldn't have a problem because I don't think I'm bad looking for somebody my age.
There she goes. For some of my age.
I see
That's
people
great.
My age.
All right. All right.
Patty, how much money did he collect yesterday?
$271, and I paid all my bills, so I'm happy.
Of course, she was part of the Money Honey contest. The videos are up on YouTube. They're terrific.
She was rolling around naked?
Yeah, it was disgusting. Yeah.
She's disturbing naked. Because it's not, and I don't mean disturbing.
She's right there,
like,
by the way.
Like, she's so disturbing nude.
Yeah,
she just looks like
Jimmy
such a
likes
Holocaust.
Her ass,
them Holocaust pictures.
Yeah,
just,
it's definitely a Holocaust.
You just
want to
throw some lie right on it.
But, but Jimmy likes her ass, and we keep trying to figure out if Jimmy's joking, but I don't think he is.
I think it's something weirdly. I don't. But it's like you would fuck Patty, I guess, if he was.
Patty brought us gifts today.
That's just a couple things. It's no big deal. I want to make a big deal out of it. You know?
Well, because of past years, I'm sure. But
there's embarrassed.
What did she bring us for Christmas?
Hold on.
Yeah, there's guys that would fuck her. There's plenty of guys.
Oh, absolutely.
There's a bunch of our listeners.
And especially if she's a virgin. That should have just... Has she fucked yet?
No.
That's her claim to fame.
We did teach her how to masturbate this year on the show.
But she gets all fucked up when she's ready to come. She, like, freaks out. I think. Look at that. Jesus Christ, Patty.
Hi, Patty. What do you got?
Okay, well, first of all, here's the card.
You give Opie the card so he can read it.
Is there a gift certificate in this?
Anthony, this is for
Patty,
you.
I get the little tiny bag.
Patty, is this a...
And Opie gets the big bag.
Is there a gift certificate?
As per the stalking of Opie.
And, she gave you Christmas gifts in a bag that is evidently from her house.
No, it's from where
it was,
I work.
Yeah, it was from where you work, but it's from your house.
Yeah, it's no big deal.
Oh, my God. She actually writes out her own cards.
I do. I don't like pre-made cards. I'd rather do my
flavor,
own.
Shut up. Different flavored cocoa mix. So I could sit and drink some hot cocoa.
Yeah.
Thank you, Patty.
How fast is that going in the garbage?
No.
Are you holding a can open while you're driving down a fucking LIE?
I'd be thrown into fucking cabbies. A dirty cabbies windshields.
I keep all Starbucks stuff.
Do you?
Why is mine wrapped?
It's not wrapped.
Oh. Here's the card that you wrote to the show. Dear O-A-N-J. I want to wish you the best holiday ever. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of the show and for making my life more interesting. You're the best, and I wish you good things always. Here's to 2008 and another fun year of great radio. I'm proud and happy to be a friend of the show, always. You are number one. Sincerely yours, Patty.
Mm-hmm. Ugh.
What is this?
What is that?
She's so emotional.
I heard that. That's why. Thank you, Patty.
You're welcome.
That's coffee.
By the way, did you get your gift from this other guy?
Whoa.
What is that, a diaper?
Wrapped in a diaper.
Yours is somewhere around here, too.
Oh, great. What is it?
You might have thrown it away. This guy...
It's the same guy that gave you the car and the Nazi stuff.
Oh, I got a replica Shelby, just like mine.
Yeah.
And I got a bunch of Nazi stuff.
Yeah.
Little flags and little arm patches from the era.
Right.
Not, reproductions. And a magazine that was from, like, 1960.
Mm-hmm.
And it had all kinds of... like Nazi rape stories in it, but not like fiction. It's like the Nazi rape tents of Egypt. It's like this weird,
that's
fucking old erotica.
And some guy that looked like Harrison Ford is like trying to stop the rapes.
Well, I guess Bill sent that, and it was very thoughtful. He knows a lot about you, and that's a fine gift, right?
Yeah.
Well, Bill sent me something, too. It's wrapped in diapers.
It's wrapped in diapers, yeah.
And it just
says...
It's
nasty, even without shit in it.
Oh, I know.
It says, Opie, you are a hard person to get a gift for. These plates have been in my family for a long time.
Aw.
I wanted you to have them. Please handle them with care.
What a smartass. Uh-huh. Make sure they...
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Here's where Opie hurts himself before vacation. Oh, watch your eyes. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, boy.
He's making it. It's clay now. Oh, my God.
Oh, there's glass dust everywhere.
Oh, shit.
And diaper dust.
Glass and diaper.
Thank you. I know, very predictable.
I think you just pounded a hole through the console.
Yeah, right? Is that console dust?
Oh.
Now I need that mask again from yesterday with Tippy Tom.
Anyone itching today, by the way?
What?
Did they clean all the bugs out of the studio?
Bed bugs?
I don't know,
lice?
Man. I have no idea.
Wow, that is really dusty.
Those plates were made with asbestos.
Yeah, right? He's just killed us.
Butters is checking in to say hi. Butters! This is Doug Stanhope's friend from Arizona. What's up, Butters?
Hey, little boys. How's it going?
Hello.
Butters, you still listening to the show?
Oh, always, every day, guys.
Thank you, sir. What do you got?
All right, two things. One, I wanted to ask Patrice a question. Two, I've got a gift for you guys. But can I ask Patrice a question first?
Yeah. Sure.
He's gay, by the way.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Well, Doug thinks you are.
I don't know. But anyway, Patrice, when I'm trying to, like, hit on a chick, I pretty much think I defeat myself in the beginning because I've had, like, really bad luck with women and stuff. So I was wondering, is there, like, any tips you have on not to feel defeated before you ask them out?
I don't know. I want to dump you right now, and I don't... I just want to... I want to break up with you.
I'm not in the right mind right now. I'm on Vicodin. I had wrist surgery about yesterday, so...
I don't think you can come out of it. I mean, as we know, like, Opie, it's like, this is... Yeah, this is like... It's hard to tell a guy how to have confidence. I'm not a help with... fucking
yeah,
the higher level bullshit like happiness,
not relationship, like, just, shit. You were talking about devious,
I'm not, yeah,
fucking,
I'm not the pickup,
fucking,
I'm not a pickup artist because you know, shit, everybody got their own style. I wish I was one of these dudes that had a six pack and just walk down the street and show a bitch my stomach and get a bitch. But
oh, I thought you meant beer when you said that.
I was like drink this bitch.
Well, sometimes that works
and,
too.
And put this pill in it. It's delicious.
It wasn't even a thought that you would actually have good abs. I'm sorry.
Exactly. I'm so far away from a nice body.
Right, when you said six pack, it's like it has to be beer.
Hey, you know, when I'm trying to get my hips in condition, really.
You can't teach someone confidence.
Yeah, it's hard to do, dude.
We
it's
all
so
lack it
do.
On some level.
Because it just comes from the fact of it's like that. I keep going back to this two girls, one cup. It's like, this is why we hate women. It's all the shit we got to do to find out that they just shit in a cup. We have to have a nice house. Like, your status is so far above pussy. But in reality, it only makes you level with pussy. If you meet a chick in the street, the fact that she has a pussy and you have an entire existence matches up.
That's even Steven.
It's fucking disgusting. You got an education, you got a home, you got a this, you got a that, and then you still have to have confidence? Bitch, my credit score is 750. I gotta have confidence too? Like a motherfucker like this, like Butter should just be able to walk up to a girl and go, look, I got pills.
Yeah.
You wanna share my Vicodin, bitch? Like, yeah. But it's all the shit we gotta do just to fuck them, and they think that should be now. That should be credibility for them to be with me for the rest of my fucking life. And like my girl, like I tell my girl, she goes, look, she goes, I love you. And this, like, I love you too. Cause we worked out this deal where she's married to me right now. Like she wants to have my last name and all that, but I'm not ready to marry her, but she could be in love with me enough to be my wife.
You gave her a ring, didn't you?
Yeah, and I told him, make that shit whatever you want to make it.
Make that shit whatever you want to make it.
That's because you're scared inside.
To get married? I know this bitch.
You can't hand over an engagement ring and go, whatever you want it to mean, that's fine with me.
It's the rank and file you want to give her. Now, let me ask you a question. You're the general in your army. Now, your privates are going to behave differently than... Like, if you're a 5-star general, you have more credit than a 3-star general. If a 3-star general comes up to you, he's gonna go, yes, sir, but he's gonna go, and with the two fingers and go, yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah, give you that little flippy. Shit.
So, well, your girl, as
but
you
what's
keep,
wrong with, like, letting your guard down a little bit?
You can't. They're out to destroy you.
You got it, though.
Out to destroy you.
I'm enemy, not
saying
dude.
A little bit, though. It would have been nice to say, look.
Trust me, I let my guard down a little
ring.
Bit.
Let's not bullshit.
You know when our arguments happen is when I let my guard down.
All right, so make it let it down a little bit.
What is letting it down? I feed the bitch. I kiss her. I tell her I love her.
How do you let your guard down?
What is letting guard down? Go coochie coochie gumdrops?
Letting the guard down would be, look, this ring is because I love you and you're kind of my wife now.
Well,
instead
because
of like, instead of let it mean whatever you want it to mean. That's crazy.
But you know why? Because you give it to him and she'll go, this is what it means. It's like you go, look, can I just... Here's the thing, Opie, this is a fucking big problem. Men should understand, or women should understand, that it's better if a guy likes you than loves you. Love is the end for men. It's over. We have no more creativity. We don't like you anymore. We don't go, this is the whole thing about men being different than women. Ask a man by himself with two men sitting around, ask that motherfucker, are you in love? A guy would never go, yes! A guy will go, yeah, but what's your point? Why would the fuck you bring my life down by asking me, am I in love? Ask a girl, you in love? Oh, my God. Ask a girl, a guy, he just met a bitch that when he fucks her, she leaves. She don't talk that much. Yo, I met this bitch. I like this. I like the shit out of her. You're happy when you like a bitch. You're miserable when you love a bitch. So I'm trying to like my bitch and love her at the same time.
You got
to
write that book.
Right. Wow.
And I guess that's it.
Yeah.
You got to write that book, I'm telling you.
I'll do it. I'm in.
People would read your book.
I'm in. I just want to stay happy. It trickles down from me.
Right on.
It should.
Anybody else out there have anything?
It works for him.
That's why I can't be no woman president.
One more question.
One more. Fuck your shit up.
Yeah, she bleed every month for no reason. How the fuck she going to run the country?
One more question, because then we do line of the day and start our vacation.
Oh, it's home.
Yeah, got to get out.
What do you got, sir?
It's more like a situation. Me and this girl, I'm dating for like a week, and we kicked a few back. We're back in my apartment out of school. We're messing around. I got finger blasted her a little bit. Good. And then she just passes out. So I'm like, all right, this sucks. So like 10 minutes later, I see her wake up. She goes and sits in my computer chair that I have next to my desk. And she just pisses all over the place.
Nice.
How do I tell her? Like, I'm so embarrassed to even talk to her about it. Like, and it's really pissing me off.
Why do you need to tell her?
That doesn't bother you if somebody pissed on your chair? Like, that would...
And no, that's when you're fucking rookie.
Hey, man.
You use that for fucking weaponry later when the bitch opened her mouth. That's why you pissed in my chair, bitch, last week. Like, why are guys so faggoty now? So what? She pissed in your fucking chair, you snitch. Leave her alone.
Plus, she doesn't give blowjobs anyway.
That's
so
your
thing. Be able to bust
you
her
see,
mouth.
He's a Revenge World guy. I love Revenge World. You ever see Revenge World?
No,
it's really it's a site where guys just put up pictures of their ex-girls or some bitch they're mad at. It makes no sense. There's no reason to ever snitch a girl out. That's your fault. Whatever's happening, if you can't get your dick sucked, it's not their fault. Understand, they don't want to suck your dick. Ready? In a nutshell. Guys are trying to get pussy without having to give up time. Women are trying to get time without having to give up pussy. Do you understand what that means? So if you're a fucking asshole that lets her hang around and suck up your space and pee all over your chairs and she's not anteing up no pussy, that's your fault, motherfucker. Mm-hmm. Your fault.
That's right.
Tell that bitch to suck your dick or leave. Take an L.
Take an L.
Take a fucking L.
Be prepared to say fuck you get
beat
lost.
Beat it, bitch. Go. Pissy chair, bitch. Get out.
Pissy chair, bitch.
She doesn't. He's trying to get revenge for not getting a blowjob. That's your fault.
Revenge don't do shit to her.
Yeah, dude, stop. Well, how do I tell her she peed in my chair? I want to tell her and hurt her feelings. It's ridiculous. It's our fault, fellas. Can we understand that?
All right, Patrice.
Thank you.
We want to start our vacation. You're, you know,
God damn, that's great.
So we can get the fuck out of here before noon.
I'm ready to end me too.